Welcome to this YouTube video, and today is going to be part one of my power hacksaw build. Enjoy. Alright, so basically right here I have our pieces of wood that we drilled a hole into, and we have these bearing pillow blocks, so I'm going to try and put our axle and rail onto this, so I'll have to fool around with it and see what works best. Alright, so basically I'm going to use this piece of steel for the drive arm, so I'm going to put a hole here and here, then we'll put it in. Alright, so now I'm going with a new design. I have this linear bearing I just bought from Home Depot, and I mounted it on the hacksaw, so this should give us a smooth, straight cut. So now we just need to put this on. Alright, so now I've upgraded the jig a little bit. So for starters, I put some more screws into the base so it's secured well, and I put a piece of wood and some screws up here. Then I replaced our steel rod with a piece of wood, and this thing has zero flex in it, so this thing's nice and solid. And so now we're just going to put our hacksaw and our rail in, and the bearings, and then we'll test it. Alright, so I added in a few more things. I replaced our drive arm with wood. I'll tell you in a second. Then I put a linear bearing on top, then I mounted the drill press vise. So first off, we'll start off with our drive arm. So I put ball bearings in this, and it fits nicely into the wood. And so that pretty much gives us an insanely smooth drive arm. So now for the linear bearing. So the linear bearing I put on top simply because our hacksaw was having too much wobble going back and forth, and this eliminates a lot of it. And then to eliminate it even more, I put in this L bracket and I bolted it to our hacksaw. And so what this does is that when I shake it up and down, you can't really see it now because this is clamped down. When I tighten the screws, I can adjust the angle of the blade. And so that gives us some customizable options to tune it in to get it perfect. And so here's an example. Well, here's an example of a cut earlier today. It's not really straight at all. So look right here. Then after, this is a cut with the tuning in process somewhat. Camera stand's falling. So it's not perfect, but it is much better than this. So overall, I'm very pleased. So I'll pick this up on another day, then we'll continue.